Hey guys, you Broken Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where I last time left off. He beat Man City in the final of the League Cup to pick up the first bit of silverware of the season. And now, my focus is locked on for the League and the FA Cup. First up, which of both I am playing in both in this episode. First up is the League. And I'm playing against Burnley. Now you will notice Rivermore is up front with Sadio Mane. Hey, Daniel Sturridge, which is energy levels for some reason are about half. I'm hoping he might make an appearance in the second half. And now you're probably wondering why am I playing Rivermore, who can't seem to score or save his life, over Emre Moore, who's scored in almost every game he's played in. Actually, I think he has scored in every game he has played in so far. Because I want to get the monkey off of Rivermore's back. I think if he scores one, that will give him what he needs, the confidence that he needs to get more. So
hi there everybody, Martin Tyler here.
Also, poor Burnley, they couldn't depict a worse time to play than me, especially in the position they are. They are bottom of the table, 14 points off safety, and I am on my way to try and win the league. So yeah, not exactly a good time to play. Need the team top of the league and hunt for that league title if you're bottom of the league. Desperate, needed points. And that says it all, doesn't it? Burnley haven't won an away game in this season. Only 5 points. The stats say it all, doesn't it?
Two changes for Liverpool. Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper.
Well, Burnley beat Liverpool. Sadio Mane up front. That's not the focus of this match. The focus of this match is to beat Burnley in this match and get one game closer to the league title. Unfortunately for any Burnley fan, it will send your team one game closer back to the championship. But what can you do?
Now Sadio Mane.
I didn't come up with the schedule, and I'm damn sure not to blame for you being in the 20th. Rivermore! Oh my god!
He's just got overexcited there. We all thought he was going to score.
He still hasn't scored. With each chance he misses, is I can't imagine the mental monkey on his back is getting bigger and bigger. Milner. There's a foul on for me, no? Playing the advantage, Rivermore.
Out in front of goal.
It's gonna come to Milner! It's in! It's a Rivermore assist, Sadio Mane. He looked like he was trying to get it in himself. I don't know where he left it or he just missed. Either way, it is James Milner's goal. And it's one.
Talk about luck. The keeper makes a good save, but straight into the path of the attacker. And I want to see this again, this goal.
You can see how close Mane was actually to getting there. I wonder if he would have been onside.
So the first goal is 1-0.
Well, It's Milner's goal, regardless of whether or not Sayama and he did try to steal, which he did.
Pressing on. Here's the cross.
Good defensive work there by Nathaniel Klein, who in between this episode and the last episode has asked for a new contract, so he's currently negotiating that. I was happy to give him a new contract. Strangely, he's the first player in the starting 11 to ask.
And in he goes with the tackle. And the ball knocked away long.
Man, it feels like he was fouled there. Or whether nothing was given.
And the ball goes out for a goal kick.
Something will be given here, it'll be a goal kick. Thumbs up from that player. I wonder if that means, like, maybe he was hurt and the thumbs up is to signal he's okay. Livermore.
That's a very good tackle, but it's led to
he wins the corner from Ward.
And it's a header.
Mane! Not quite in the back of that.
Well, I hope we get the same sort of game that we got in the reverse fixture, when the team that's at home now won absolute
Firmino.
Amazing. Well, the goalkeeper will hope that it stays.
For some reason, Rubemore left it. That's who I played it to. I didn't intend that as a pass for Sadio Mane, but for some reason, Rubemore didn't go for it. And Gray or offside. Okay. You dirty piece of shit.
Here's a chance to move forward from midfield after that interception. Good forward play from them. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. Coutinho.
Is Philippe Coutinho.
Tackle here.
Alaba. One more.
This is a good opportunity. Put the ball into the penalty area now.
Try and make his way through. To Rubemore! Denied by the keeper. Another miss. Another chance. Blown. Another opportunity. He didn't put away.
The referee blows. He started the second half here at Anfield. Attacking well here.
Rubemore.
The shot's on.
Goes for a glorious shot. Oh, that would have been absolutely fantastic with he score your first goal. Well, the cheeky he chip. Cheeky. Yeah, attempt at a Rubemore there. I was kind of hoping the ball would fall to Rich Hand there, but it didn't. Here's Rubemore. Alaba. Goes for it! Oh, what a save.
To show how good they are at corners that maybe increase their advantage.
This keeper may not be Heaton, but he's saving a lot of shots like Heaton would if he were here. Not sure where he is. Maybe he's on the bench, I don't know. I didn't let the game show me the Burnley lineup. It's so I cannot confirm or deny whether Tom Heaton is on the Burnley bench. I'm not sure why he would be, considering he's probably the best keeper in the league right now in terms of form. Super stop by the goalkeeper. If you can hear my dog barking, just ignore him, and he won't shut up.
Emre Can. Barnes. We've had an hour gone here, and there's still 30 minutes left. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
I don't know if you can hear him, that's why I said if you can hear him. Because I can hear him, and he's annoying the hell out of me.
Here on EA Sports, we're presenting the quarter-final FA Cup fixture for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Aston Villa. Yeah, you get to this stage, Martin, and you can almost smell Wembley.
Come on, for fuck's sake.
Good challenge.
Sadio Mane is in through. Oh, Bruno Mars won the ball for Kane there. He would have had an easy. The opportunity. Firmino! What was that? That was pathetic, Firmino. I think now is a good time to bring on Daniel. I think Ruben Morris had a decent opportunity. I mean, you can't say much more than I gave him 71 minutes and he still didn't score. See, this is... Actually, I won't say... Hey, you can probably guess. By his bad form.
So what about Burnley's next game? Yeah, they're playing Sunderland in the next match. And I don't hold out high hopes for them.
Maybe he'll have one last opportunity. Before we're going off. Rivermar. Nope. He's just going to lose the ball. Coutinho! Not today. For the little magician. Too far off target, and that's gonna signal the arrival of the Hood, Genie Wijnaldum, and Daniel Sturridge. Yep, all three substitutions made at once because why the hell? I've gotten lucky, and I don't think anyone. Has gotten injured from in an actual match so far. All the injuries have occurred during training. Sturridge whips it in. Sadio Mane! Oh, he's missing it!
Here's the cross.
Nathaniel Clyne! Oh!
Fantastic game, this.
It's going to go. Play ball. Genie
Wijnaldum. Midfield area.
Who last weekend scored his first goal for Liverpool. Won't be very memorable, considering it was goal number 6. But, hey, it was a goal nonetheless. Good for you, Genie. Good for you. I feel bad, because Daniel Sturridge really deserved it. I mean, come on and deserve to have almost a hat-trick worth of chances is within about 5-10 minutes is unbelievable. Well, Daniel Sturridge does not want Jurgen Klopp to forget that he's around, does he?
Champions Cup. Roma 0, CSKA Moscow 1.
Crazy.
Burnley.
I think now is a good time to talk about the thing I was gonna talk about, but I said I'd leave it until this opportunity because, of course, now it's more prominently an thing. As you can see, I've also offered a few other players contract extensions. Ryan Kent, I wasn't expecting Ilori to accept his, to be honest. In fact, he's actually going to be playing this next game, because it'll be the second team playing. Just make sure I can see the team. The date in for a switch. And there you can see what Rimomar's poor form has done. Yeah, it's cost him his spot in the second team. Moya is taking it. Rimomar is still going to be on the bench, but, I mean, I don't know if he's even going to get an opportunity. I mean, he might have to go on loan next season. That's how bad it's seeming. I don't want to do that. I really want to give him the opportunity, but he's not making it easy. He's really not. And this is the first time I'm playing Villa in FIFA 17. Because, of course, they are not in the Premier League anymore. But, having looked at the championship table recently, they are up there in the playoff position, so they could be on their way back. So, this could be my one and only game against them while they are in the championship. Although, teams that get promoted in career modes don't seem to last very long. They almost all seem to go down, with the odd exception. It's like the opposite of real life. If you can almost guarantee the teams that came up will go down. Almost sometimes one will stay up, but it will only be narrow. So it doesn't bode well for Newcastle fans either, because you're top of the championship at when I checked it before the start of this video, so that would mean, unless that streak is going to end with the likes of whoever comes up for the second season to replace what's looking like Burnley and Leicester and probably Watford.
Doesn't affect their performances. He could be the star turn for Liverpool today. Always catch
them. I don't get why Genie won out on this player watch.
In a very intelligent way.
Some other their players to watch.
4-4-2. Yeah, I think it looks that way, Martin. Yes, it's the conventional shape. It's the one that the manager prefers. The Aston Villa team for this game.
This is the one player game. And so please keep your eye on every player who's in the screen at any given time. Because you never know what's going to happen.
To a throw. Throw in for Liverpool.
Also, how weird is it that both of my strikers, Moore and Moya,
defender to it first.
That's the new combination, ladies and gentlemen. Eminem!
On the attack here. That's great defending there, stopping that attack.
Forget SAS. Eminem.
Now the shot! Oh, great work by the keeper.
Good save by the keeper.
That's a corner, not
and
on the
takes
money.
The corner two. Right, so yeah, you can make a run anytime soon. Alexander Arnold.
some width into this attack. A bit of pressure on the player, that's why it's gone out.
Forced out play. It's going to be a little throw. Damn it! I thought I had it there. Not the case.
Well, he's read that, hasn't he?
Alexander Arnold.
The interception made it look easy, actually. Attacking well here.
Oh, yeah. Cuts it back for Arnold. Beautiful. Oh, play. And a beautiful finish. 1-0.
He saw the gap down in the bottom corner.
This is a little inadvertent 1-2, as it were, because it was Arnold who gave the ball to. Oh, yeah. And this set. Ever so gently tucked into the corner of the net. Somehow that's his first goal in the FA Cup when he got a good few in the Capital One Cup.
Micah Richards. Gardner. Nice bit of interplay between these two. He's coming forward with some danger. Here the challenge is a good one. Emre Moore. Undergoing a real period of
reaction.
Anfield, building from the back of the main stand over the top.
Diawara. Moore. Can't get past all those players. I probably shouldn't have tried to go through them, to be honest. Maybe. Calabria. Bun will easily clear that. Gini Wijnaldum.
Left his marker there cleverly. Probing away.
Gomez.
Room for a shot, maybe.
Puts it in. Oh, it's almost found its way to Alexander Arnold.
There's good progress with this attack.
Fusa Mensah. Oh, come on, ref! I was pressing square to cross. That is so BS. I pressed square cross. Your man just happened to run into me. He at that period. I did not try to challenge him there. That was not what was planned. Oh, but that makes up for it. What a goal from Alexander Arnold. That is how you bag a pace. He's in some style. A little over from Mora. He lets it fly to Arnold, and it's just superb. Bun tries his best, but it's just too good not to have gone in, to be honest. There's a beautiful ace for the youngster.
It's looking good, this move. Unmarked now, he's lost his marker. Good pull one back here.
Oh, and Ayu could pull one back there for the being made an absolute mess of it. And still two.
He's left his lines like that.
Got the ball back, the interceptor got it for them. Attacking now.
This might be it.
Good save. Hey, Bayou again! Denied this time by Gini Wijnaldum. We got back to do some defensive work. No, often you see a central attacking midfielder do that. Even though he's left mid in this game. His natural position is at cam.
They've coped with it well defensively. Well, that is a cheap.
Richards. Samantha clears it and there's half done with.
And it should be enough to get them through into the semi-finals.
2-0 at the break. Both goals coming from Alexander-Arnold. Fantastic work.
Now it's time to go again for the second 45 minutes in this quarter-final of the Emirates FA Cup.
Well, the players really went at it in the first half, and you wonder whether we're going to see some tired legs as the second half wears on.
Oh, yeah. More. Go. Go, 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 go. Oh, come on.
It worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. Gary Gardner. These two have got a great understanding with their passing. Gardner. Here comes the challenge. Nothing wrong with that tackle.
No foul there on Moore, really? Well, that's some bullshit. Diawara. Great ball to Emery Moore! 3-0. Well, that is progression. Let's see. Well, I'm in the same defense. Well, Emery Moore has another FA Cup goal to add it to his collection. As they were not the prettiest goal, but in the end, they do all count. Yes, we give him points for getting the ball up. Up, despite being so close to the keeper. It's four goals already in the FA Cup.
3-0 as the game gets underway. McCormack.
He made his debut in this competition. Did more.
To be some alteration to the structure for Villa. The substitute's going to come on.
I think that's four goals in three FA Cup games. Until I'm not mistaken.
Half an hour to go. And here comes the counter-attack.
Could be. What I'm not mistaken about is it's 4-0 and it's definitely over. Moya has scored more goals in 61 minutes of FA Cup games than and Rivermar has in all the games he's played so far.
I think you're going to be playing with an awful lot of confidence to try that, and he is.
Look how much he towers over the keeper and everything. Freaking hell, this dude is humongous. It's also a not his first FA Cup goal either. First he made his
by the Liverpool man.
First impact in the FA Cup. And that's another really soft yellow card, referee. This time it's for Emery Moore. Suppose I should count myself lucky that it's not a second for Texan. Alexander-Arnold, because that's who it could have been. I'm pretty sure he's over on the other side of me. Yeah, I can see him. Going into position. Of course, the referee's not going to give any foul. Was against the computer, because that would be just bizarre. That is not the fair.
McCormack.
But you're right. Who needs to be fair?
Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. This could be it.
Moya. Hey! That's a cheap corner that I just got there.
Well, you can see from the graphic how busy he's been around that 18-yard box. Really has kept the keeper busy. Got some reward too.
Obviously, smartly marking Moya He's about 10 feet tall. Oh. Seriously, how did I get such a tall player? Look how much he's towering over everyone.
Throw in. Need to try and get the ball back now. McCormack. And the away team want to make a change.
Come on. So the good challenge, Ginny. What happened? Oh, of course. I'm surprised he didn't give Wijnaldum a booking.
4-0 here.
There we go. This time, maybe he won't give a foul against another good challenge. This referee. He knows this bullshit now. Oh, it's not like he can bullshit me out of this one. Okay. Penalty! Thank you very much. He actually gave a decision. And it's a freaking miracle. Really? That's only a yellow. With the yellows you gave me, he should be off. Off. It's not a red card challenge, but compared to the ones you gave yellows for me, he may pretty much as well be. Looks like it will be. Genie went out of the... for three. Fine, now, sorry. Again. Oh, cut off. And Genie Wijnaldum does make an impact on this match. Not a big one. And again, it's like the goal gets a Watford. It's a goal to seal, 5-goal win. And that doesn't really seem too important in the grand scheme of the match. But I'm sure Wijnaldum will take it. I think that's only his second goal of the season for me. Yeah, might be wrong. I know he has another goal. I think it was in the League Cup. Or it might have been... No, I think it was in the League Cup.
The game underway again. Sometimes being a favourite in a match can weigh heavily, expectation and all that. It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponent.
Credit to Villa, they're still going for that consolation, though. Well, it won't make you feel any better, to be honest. It's, although, I don't know if I can convince them to stop. Not by saying, it won't make you feel better.
Defended to it first.
Yeah, I don't know, it's not exactly who you want on the end of cross. Moya on the other hand, if he gets into the right position, do not give a foul against me. Yeah. Knowing this game, it would have. But it didn't, and that is the end of this match. It's a comfortable progression. 2 goals from Texas. Zanarnold. A goal for Ray Moore and Moya, and a goal from the penalty spot from Genie Wijnaldum. It's all good in the hood. We are through to the semi-final of the FA Cup. And with the win in against Burnley in the first game, we are one step closer to the league title. Well, you can see some of the other results. Man United defeated Newcastle. Manchester City are through as well, having beaten Arsenal. And Spurs beat Everton. I'm the only game that had more than one goal. Oh, United 1-0 over Newcastle. City 1-0 over Arsenal. Spurs is 1-0 over Everton. Interesting. Will I face one of the Manchester clubs in the semi-final? Or will my semi-final be against Spurs, leading to another Manchester derby? Which was actually the Manchester. There was actually a Manchester derby on in the other game. And when I was playing Burnley United were playing City. Speaking of City, they're my next league game. It's all coming together. I don't know how the game ends, but champion. It is. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash a like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And tell some of you all. Have a very nice day. Peace.